until this morning. And as we talk about him, I think you'll be impressed with the quality, the athleticism of these young men. But I wouldn't be able to, we wouldn't have been able to accomplish, you know, what we accomplished in such a short period of time without the efforts of the staff. You know, the staff did a tremendous job in really a two-week period to go out and evaluate these young men, and then go out and sell the University of Connecticut to them and their families. So again, my hat's off to them and the hard work that they did and the relentless pursuit to secure these commitments. And then again, you know, we were blessed with having great support systems, you know, here at UConn. Not only here in football, in the Burton Family Football Complex, but also over in Gamble with David Benedict and Beth Getz and their staff, and all the effort that went into getting everything done and getting the letters out to these kids and putting the weekends together. So again, we're thankful for having a great team in place to be able to do that. You know, it was an interesting process that we kind of went through. When we got here, we evaluated as much of the tape of the current team as we could to see where we were with our roster, but then also take a look at where the needs would be for this class, and then went and evaluated the kids that we knew about, and then also some other young men that we knew that would fit the system that we were going to run here. And so we were able to go out and really get some really quality offensive linemen, which I thought was a priority for us in this class, and guys that have size already. And now what we've got to do is just teach them the techniques and the fundamentals that it takes to play at this level. I thought we were able to get an outstanding group of quarterbacks. I'm a firm believer that it all starts under the center, and you got to have, you know, somebody there that can pull the trigger. And I think we have three young men that will come in and provide tremendous competition for what we want to be able to do offensively. Got some size and speed and athleticism at the wide receiver position, which I thought was something that we needed to do, is to increase our overall athleticism of our team, but also I thought that we needed to upgrade the team's speed, and I think we did that at wide receiver. We're going to have an experienced running back coming in, somebody who's played in the SEC and shown his ability to be productive in a league of that nature, and come here and be able to compete for us. Ryan Fitton, a tight end from Staples High School, young man that has really good size to him, good kid, good work ethic, strong blocker, very versatile from the tight end position. And then on defense, I thought we needed to really shore up some things and help ourselves in the secondary. We were able to get you know, three corners that bring length and athleticism and some speed to the corner position, and then some guys at safety that have the ability to come up and play the run, but also be able to play the coverages and man-to-man that, things that we would like to do. You know, we were able to get a young man to change from a school and then come here from Windsor. T.J. Gardner was you know, an outstanding two-way player, running back, linebacker, was going to be a linebacker here. And, you know, he just had an affection and affinity for UConn and wanted to be here. So that was one thing that was really good. The same really with Ryan Fitton, another in-state kid. So we want to keep those kids home as much as we can. Darian Beavers is a long athletic, going to be an outside linebacker for us. Was a safety in high school, 6'4", 215 pounds. And then also nose tackle Caleb Thomas is a young man that we really liked his quickness off the ball and just how he played at that position. So We addressed the needs that I thought we needed to have. You know, again, we're finished for now, but we will also continue to work to build our roster as we go forward. You know, if there's people that do come available, fifth-year grad students, people of that nature, then again, that's something that we're always going to be looking to do, is to always keep our roster the best we can and create as much competition, you know, as we possibly can. So, you know, overall, you know, very, very pleased, very, very happy. And again, I can't say enough about the assistant coaches in terms of the work that they put in and such a team effort. And, you know, three or four guys going into a home to see kids and, you know, spending the time that it took to be able to be as successful as we were, you know, here today. So if there's any questions, I'll be more than happy to answer.
Hi, Randy. Welcome back.
Thanks.
Patty Mark from the Associated Press. Can you talk about how important it was for you to still have the ties that you had the last time you were here, and how did that work into the
Well, that did help quite a bit, you know, because going into some of these areas and, you know, coaches recognized you, and also coaches called us up to talk about some of the young men. So that familiarity, you know, with the areas that, you know, that we were recruiting in was very beneficial. And then also very beneficial to have people here in place that were here before when I was here to be able to help us, you know, pull off the weekends. Ellen Tripp and her staff, Bob Howard, everybody. So I think that was a big factor for us to be able to have success, not only people here on our campus, but also having the connections and the ties with the high school coaches and people in these areas where we went to where we went to recruit.
Hey, Ed Gable from Bloomberg. How do you compare this time around with your first class to the way it did in 1998?
Well, we're in a whole different situation now, because we were, at that point in time, you know, we were looking to, you know, go and make the jump from, you know, 1AA to 1A. So here it was more of, I knew what was in place here, but I said, you know, I felt that then we went and kind of just recruited athletes, you know, and guys that we felt could be, really be backups and special teams guys as we made that jump. This time, I mean, these are guys that we feel that can come in and compete, you know, right away. And that's the that's the challenge that we told, you know, all these young men, that, because they would ask, some of them would ask about redshirting. And, you know, I told them, I said, redshirting, that's up to you. I don't make that decision. I watch what you do, and then, you know, I'll decide come the end of August if we're leaning that way to redshirt you. So I want these guys to have the mindset to, you know, start working out this afternoon to start to prepare themselves, you know, for when they come here in June for the summer program, and then we'll go from there. So again, I think that's the biggest difference. These are guys that we're looking at to come in, and, you know, some of them probably will be performing in the fall, some of them might not, but again, we like everything about them, but I think it's just a different mindset this time around.
Yeah.
Gavin Keith from London today. What were some of the questions that the recruits had for you regarding the state of the program and everything?
You know, they get into a little bit more of what you're going to do schematically, you know, offensively and defensively. And, you know, the other thing that was a lot easier for me this time around was I knew what to sell. When I was here the first time, I didn't have anything to sell or know what to sell. You know, this time it was a little bit easier. And they would ask about the number of guys in the NFL. They would ask about, you know, graduation rates and things that we do. So, you know, now I had 12 years of knowledge and information that I was able to use in the home and have examples of guys who have gone on to be successful away from the football world, but also guys that have continued, you know, their career in football. So, There was a lot of different questions, but a lot of times what I tried to do was to cover all the things so they wouldn't, couldn't ask questions. I answered it before they could ask it.
Other questions, folks?
Randy, there's obviously some national criticism of one kid in particular. Just how hard is it for you when you come into a situation where you have commitments from previous staff and letting kids know where they stand, how that process
works? Well, again, you know, that's something that we can't address because we can't talk about you know, anybody that's not signed. But again, you try to make the best decisions for the program and what you think is best. And sometimes when that happens, people don't agree with you.
Mike.
Hey, Randy. Mike. Can you tell us about the process with T.J. Gardner? What you felt like, when you felt like he might be available, and just how that dialogue went on.
Well, that was a situation where, you know, we got in here and, you know, we found out that that he might have an interest in Connecticut. So we had contacted him, we pursued it, and as we continued to pursue it, there was a situation where maybe he wasn't, you know, gonna go ahead and change his mind. But then we got a phone call back from him where he said that, you know, he wanted to come up and he wanted to visit and he wanted to see UConn because that was a place where, you know, he always wanted to see himself at. So we brought him in, you know, last weekend, and he decided that this was the place, you know, where he wanted to be, which made us, you know, very, very happy because he is a quality football player, he's a quality person. He's from down the road in Windsor, and you know, that's a school that, you know, Rob Fleeting has done a very good job. And we're going to have some young men from Windsor on our team right now. So that's a pipeline that we want to be involved with. And, you know, the guy that's a principal there is a pretty good friend of mine. So, you know, again, you try to use all your connections, you know, in recruiting.
And Rob,
how
about
David is just an outstanding young man. You know, he went to Oakland Mills down there in Howard County, not very far from where I was located when I was down in that area. But really, he didn't play football till late, and so, you know, he got involved and then went to Lackawanna, and again, that, you know, the competition at Lackawanna is, you know, a little bit better than in high school, so he has that experience. The thing that I like about it, you know, with him is, you know, he was 10-1 as a starter, you know, so he's a winner, he knows how to win, and he's also a guy that is very, you know, calm in terms of how he handles himself and how he goes about his business. But he has the ability to both, you know, run and throw. And but he's a really good kid and a really good leader. And you know, that's the same thing with Martin and Jordan. I mean, those guys are winners. You know, and in that position, you know, you want guys that are good leaders, you want guys that are winners, and you know, those guys are all three of them. You know, are winners and they're good leaders and they have these personalities about them that are, like I said, very, very calming, and it doesn't seem like a whole lot of gratitude, which is really what you want in the quarterback.
It's pretty rare for offensive linemen to come in and play in their first year. Obviously, there were some struggles on the line with this team last year. Is it realistic to think that one or two, maybe they got a shot at earlier?
I would say maybe a couple of them might have a little bit, you know, Robert Holmes, you know, he could have a chance, you know, physically and strength-wise, you know, Ryan Vandermark, I mean, he's a big, broad shoulder guy. He'll be a 300 pounder easily before it's all said and done. And James Tunstall, again, he's another guy that has the size and has good athletic ability. But again, a lot of it depends on how quickly some of these guys can pick things up. You know, I always use the saying that the closer you are to the football, the harder it is to play, early. You know, the further away you are from the football, the better opportunity you might have to play early. But size-wise with some of these guys, and strength-wise, like I said, Robert Holmes is a guy, size and strength-wise. Now, how quickly can they master the fundamentals and techniques and pick up the terminology and, all that, all those things? That's the tough part. That's the tough part for those guys.
Don Labiano, BC Connecticut. Coach, did you enjoy recruiting again under Dean Capitan here? You said it was easy to contact, but how did you enjoy it? Or if you did enjoy it?
Oh, I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it a lot. Getting back out on the road and visiting with people. Starting one day where we got up at 3 o'clock in the morning here and took a flight down to Baltimore and hit five kids in Baltimore and then finished up at 9 o'clock at night and drove up to Princeton, New Jersey. We got there about 11 o'clock and saw Ryan the next morning, and then we drove to Philly to see another young man, to see Robert King, and then we drove out to Cumberland to see Brady Brown, and to see him the next morning, then drove back 2.5 hours with BWI to fly to Orlando or West Palm to see Robert, and then drive up to see Marvin, and come back. So it was a lot of fun, Carome and I put on a lot of miles, and Baltimore, the big circle that we took, and then Rhett and I put on some miles down to Florida. But it's fun because you get around, high school coaches, you get around these kids and their families, and again, the right kind of young men too, so it was fun. It was fun to be able to go out and sell UConn, to sell them and in terms of what these young men can come here and accomplish. And the neat thing was, anything that these guys want to accomplish, for the most part, we've done it here. When you talk to them about getting your degree and the graduation rates that we have, and then the guys who are out there in the professional world working, there's examples that you can use for those guys. A number of we've had first round draft choices here. I've coached those guys. Second round we had, I think at one time, 25 active guys 1 year in the NFL from UConn. We've won championships. We've won bowl games. So we've done all those things here. So again, it's great to be able to go out and have that kind of ammunition and that kind of resume to be able to use with the young kids, because people that might try to use things against you. And, getting back to Ed's question, before, we didn't have any of that. We were building from the ground up. But now, we have a resume that's pretty darn strong here to be able to sell, that people can't go and punch a lot of holes in. So I think that aided us in being able to have the kind of success that we had in such a short period of time. And now what we want to do is, continue to build that resume and make it better, so as we continue to recruit year after year, we're going to be even bigger and stronger than we were this past year.
Wayne Norman, UConn Radio Network. Hi, Randy. You had a lot of success here in your UConn days with a fullback. That's one reason you had such great running backs here. Do any of these guys equate out to the fullback? I see one running back. Or do you plan on using the fullback or using guys that are already in the program in a fullback spot?
Well, again, based on what we'll end up doing offensively, the one thing I think you see nowadays is you can take tight ends and use tight ends and utilize them, in the backfield and do certain things, and then they might be a little bit more versatile for you, in the passing game. So, again, that was one thing. I think we had six tight ends on scholarship. So again, and I'll tell you, Wayne, to be honest with you, there's not many fullbacks out there because high schools don't even use fullbacks anymore because of the style of offenses that everybody plays. But you can find those guys at those hybrid tight ends that can go in and do those things. And I just use an example. I mean, this past year in Detroit, we had a fullback, but he might have played 3 to 4 plays a game. That was it. A lot of that was probably short yardage and goal line. So the fullback is kind of a dying breed almost. And because of some of the things that you can do, you know, the tight ends, and there's more of those nowadays than there are fullback because not too many people just use a fullback anymore in high school.
Ian Bethune, the UConn blog. Can you talk about the recruitment of Marvin Washington? He was out, he flipped late to you guys.
Yeah, I was hoping that paper was going to get in here this morning. But no, when, you know, the thing is, it says something about Dr. Phillips. Dr. Phillips had nine Division I signees today. So there was a lot of pictures being taken and everything else. And you know, Marvin was a young man that we got on late. Well, we got in here late, but we found out about him. Rhett found out about him through a friend of his and knew that, you know, he was committed to UCF, and then you know, he decided to back out of that commitment, and we got in the hunt with him, and we just tried to recruit him as hard as we could for the time frame that we had. And you know, he was he's a great kid. He doesn't say a whole lot, and when you sit and talk to him, you know, he's looking you right in the eye, and he's listening, he's digesting every word that you're saying. And so you needed to make sure that you were, you know, upfront and honest with him, and because, you know, as much as you try to read them, they're reading you too. And he was one of the ones that I thought that you know, was a little bit more really studying, you know, me and Brett when we would end up talking to him. But he, you know, he wasn't going to come up for a visit, and we went and saw him, and we told him that just come on up and take a look, because once you get up here, you're going to find out it's totally different than what you think. And so he came in last weekend, and when I sat down with him Sunday morning, you know, his dad came along with him. We were talking for a little bit, and his dad got up and he said, "Randy," he says, you and him, you guys talk. I'm leaving." You know, so his dad left, and you know, we talked about a lot of different things. He was down at Rensselaer Field because we end up down there on Sundays. You know, and we had a real good talk, and I just told him the things that I felt, you know, could happen. You know, I thought that, you know, he needed to kind of get out of his comfort zone a little bit, being from Florida, getting away, and just really had a really good conversation, you know, with him. And then finally, I think about, what was it, Monday night, you know, he told me on the phone when I called him that this is, you know, he was going to come here, but I told him that I wouldn't tell anybody, you know, about it until he was ready to, you know, make the final decision and everything else. And really, that's how we got it. I mean, it was a point to where we just had to tell him. And that's the one thing that I think, you know, T.J. Gardner's mother, you know, from Windsor, she's never been around the campus and been up here. And when she came up here and we took him around and, you know, again, talking with her throughout the weekend, and on Sunday she said, "Coach," she goes, "I never knew UConn. I've never seen UConn the way you guys presented it and seen it." And, you know, she was really taken back by, you know, everything from the academics and the support systems that we had and, you know, how we do everything. And, you know, again, kids come into this building here. And I'll tell you, one of the big things for me coming back is what they've done down the store center right there on 195. I mean, that is a game changer. You know, that is, to me, is a game changer in terms of what's taking place down there. and the kids had. So, you know, and that was one of the things that David Pendles mentioned. He wanted to go somewhere where it's college town, college atmosphere. And, you know, you get them on here, and then you take them down there, and they get to walk around and do those things. I mean, that's something that aided us a lot, because that, you know, before, there was, we didn't have anything like that. So, again, you know, as long as we can get them here on campus, you know, we'll have a chance. And we were able to get a couple kids on campus and just tell them, come on, take a look. And then once they got here, they said, wow, you know, you guys were right. And, you know, that sold a lot of kids on, you know, coming here, especially kids from a distance.